Published 1730 Eastern Standard Time, the 8th of March 2018. Updated 327 Eastern Standard Time, the 9th of March 2018. Marcus McGuane wanders into the games room at Barcelona's La Masia Academy. He glances round, passing the pool table, PlayStations and dartboard. Then he stares at the montage on the wall. The name of every player who has slept in our La Masia dormitory is etched into the tapestry. His smile broadens. There's Fabregas, he says, pointing to the Chelsea midfielder's name. As a six-year-old, I had a picture taken under his shirt in the Arsenal dressing room. Look, there's Iniesta, Puyol, and near the top is Pep Guardiola. Marcus McGuane points to Cesc Fabregas's name on the wall at Barcelona's La Masia Academy. McGuane is still settling into life in Spain, having only joined the club from Arsenal in January. The 19-year-old made his debut for Barcelona in the Catalan Super Cup on Wednesday. McGuane came on for the final 15 minutes of the match against Espanyol, which Barca won for McGuane. Every day appears to bring new joy. Barcelona were busy in England in January, prizing Philippe Coutinho from Liverpool in a £145 million transfer, yet at the foothills of the Pyrenees, Barca are feeling smug about the deal to tempt McGuane, who turned 19 last month, from Arsenal to become the first Englishman since Gary Lineker to sign for them. On the day we meet, he was invited to train with the Barcelona first team. On Wednesday night, he made his first team debut as a substitute in the Catalonia Cup final victory over Espanyol. It feels incredible, McGuane tells Sportsmail. When you go to first team training, you go into the dressing room first. That first walk was so exciting. The first person I saw was Sergio Busquets. As a central midfielder, seeing him in the flesh, one of the best in the world on the ball, his grace, technical ability. Then I saw Coutinho, then Messi. You don't want to act too star-struck, but I grew up watching these guys on television. Five of us were over there from the B team. The first teamers came up and said, hi, as they got their kits together. Coutinho heard my English accent, made me feel welcome, and said he was there if I need anything. He had been invited to train with the first team on the day Sportsmail caught up with him. A young McGuane poses with cutouts of Ronaldinho and Samuel Eto'o at the Nou Camp. McGuane, aged 6, sits under Cesc Fabregas's shirt in the dressing room at the Emirates. McGuane is adapting to life rapidly. He has moved into a city centre apartment with his girlfriend. His language lessons begin this week, and his coaches have been impressed by his maturity and quality in training. At Barcelona, they regard McGuane with fondness. José Mari Baqueiro, a crucial midfield cog in the 1992 European Cup-winning team alongside Guardiola, Ronald Koeman and Michael Laudrup, is now the club's head of youth football. He is effusive in his praise. Baqueiro says, we've brought Marcus here with the idea he can eventually go to the first team. He has fantastic physical attributes, he is two-footed, his touch is sharp, good awareness. He has all that we would look for in a midfield player for the Barcelona first team. But he must work hard. Barcelona scout Bojan Krkicsnr nods his head beside Baqueiro, adding that McGuane was monitored for over a year before the club pounced, with the player's contract set to expire in the summer. Barcelona placed a £21.9 million buyout clause in his three-year contract. For Arsenal, however, this deal represented a blow. McGuane grew up in Woolwich, first training with his boyhood club as a five-year-old, and remains indebted to his mum, Patricia, for the sacrifices she made. José Mari Baqueiro, left, and Bojan Krkicsnr, right, are both effusive in their praise of McGuane. Growing up, it was my mum and brothers, he says. To get to training, we caught three trains and a bus, walking 20 minutes from the last bus stop when I was 6 years old. Mum didn't have a clue about football, but people were saying, he's got a bit of talent. Mum listened to them and took me to the local leisure centre. She worked in accounts and juggled everything. We would get home at ridiculous times. I would train 6 to 8 p.m. and sometimes would get back at 11 p.m. It's all worth it now. In his teenage years, McGuane was regarded as one of Arsenal's brightest prospects. Yet English football has a profound development problem between the ages of 18 and 21, when opportunities are restricted by Premier League clubs choosing to spend fortunes on ready-made talent. To make matters worse, the under-23 Premier League is deemed uncompetitive by many clubs and young players. McGuane trained regularly with Arsenal's first team but was restricted to a couple of Europa League substitute appearances. He feared his progress might stall. McGuane was speaking to Sportsmail's Adam Crafton at La Masia Academy in Barcelona. McGuane was highly thought of at Arsenal and made his debut in the Europa League this term. He was getting frustrated by a lack of opportunities. He says, "It is good to train, but I did not want my performance to plateau and stay at the same level. This step made sense." Now at Barcelona, he plays in the B team in the Spanish second tier against clubs with attendances regularly over 25,000. McGuane says, "It's a competitive league. There is a lot of emphasis on winning as well as performance. People have a misconception about Spain. They think it is about how many passes you make, like they are obsessed with possession stats. It is far from true. The emphasis is on winning, but of course it matters how you win." McGuane has seen the English talent in his age group close up. He has represented England at U17, U18 and U19 level and stresses the importance of offering chances to young players who lifted World Cups for England last year. "Every manager has huge pressure to win trophies a year gone. But we can't be too scared to give youngsters opportunities. Did Arsene Wenger indicate those opportunities would come? I didn't have any conversations with him," he says. "I thought if I kept working hard, I would get opportunities. It didn't come." McGuane has stressed the importance of England's young World Cup winners getting chances. "There's no grudge, but I felt the best thing was to find another way. If you want to be at a place to develop and get first team football, maybe you have to look elsewhere than Arsenal." McGuane's path should become more familiar in the coming years. He points out that his generation have grown up worshipping players and clubs from abroad. His ex-Arsenal teammate Chris Willock moved to Benfica. Manchester City lost Jadon Sancho to Borussia Dortmund before English footballers were less adventurous. "Now we see opportunities elsewhere," he says. After Wednesday, McGuane is hungry for more chances. He smiles, "People tell me I am the first since Lineker. It's a massive achievement, but I want to be a first-teamer and will do everything to get there." McGuane's path is set to become a familiar one for a lot of English youngsters in the future.